गुड इवनिंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द मोल्डिंग, कास्टिंग एंड प्रोसेसिंग टेक्निक्स ऑफ पॉलीमर्स. सी, इट इज़ द फैक्ट दैट द पॉलीमेरिक मटेरियल्स आर यूज्ड इन मेनी फॉर्म्स सच एज रॉड्स, ट्यूब्स, शीट्स, फोम्स, कोटिंग और एडेसिव्स एंड अल्सो एज मोल्डेड एंड फैब्रिकेटेड आर्टिकल्स. Implies that there must be a variety of ways in which the compounded resins can be processed and converted into finished products. That means certain processing techniques are applied to convert that polymeric materials into finished products. See, majority of the articles are either molded or fabricated. While many others are made by casting liquid polymers into a mold and allowing them to cure or cross-link. Fibers are made by a process known as spinning. Already we discussed dry spinning, wet spinning, mild spinning. So, fibers are made by spinning process. The process of molding can be compared to making, for instance, a toy horse out of clay. That means from the clay material the toy horse is made. The fabrication process perhaps be compared to making the toy by carving it out of a soap cake. See, the comparison is made here. Okay, either from the clay material the toy horse is made, or either it is made from this soap cake by carving technique. In the molding process, the compounded material in the form of powder or chips or granules is placed in a mold of the desired shape. See, when we place the material into the mold, the desired shape and size can be obtained. But for that, heat and pressure is required to be applied. And finally, the product is obtained. You know that fabricatum items are made of simple forms such as sheet, rod or tube using processes such as cutting, shaping, gluing, bonding and welding. See, here some important processes are to be discussed, that is calendaring, casting, compression, molding, injection molding, extrusion molding, blow molding, cold foaming, thermoforming, foaming, reinforcement, mild spinning, dry spinning and wet spinning, which is already discussed. See, before taking up various processing techniques, let us recapitulate the polymeric materials can either be thermoplastic or thermosetting. Already in material science and metallurgy we differentiated thermoplastic and thermosetting. Once thermoplastic materials are molded or shaped under the heat and pressure, they are required to be cooled much below their softening temperature before being released out of the mold. Otherwise, they may get D-shaped. So, in case of thermosetting materials, however, there is no need to cool the article before releasing it out of the mold. Since once set under the influence of heat and pressure, the article does not change its shape even when handled hot. Thank you.